For today's video, we'll be taking a look at a set of DDR5 RAMs from a brand that most of you probably won't have heard of before, KingBank. Based in Shenzhen in China, KingBank manufactures a variety of memory products such as SSDs, as well as DDR5, DDR4, and even DDR3 memory modules. Now, KingBank has kindly sponsored the RAM kit in this video, a 32GB kit of what the brand calls the DDR5 Dark Heatsink model that doesn't come with RGB lighting. This particular example that I have here is the DDR5 6000 CL28 variant, and we'll unbox it and put it through some benchmark tests so as to see how it performs. Let's get started. In terms of aesthetics, the memory modules come with gunmetal grey aluminium heat spreaders, which are pretty hefty and feel pretty premium. The said heat spreaders sport a matte finish for the top half, with some aesthetic motifs in white for added visual interest, and we do also get a brushed finish for the bottom half as well. With that, let's run through the specs of the RAMs real quick. As mentioned earlier, this is a 32GB DDR5 6000 CL28 kit that comprises two 16GB memory modules, where according to the table on the screen, which I've lifted from KingBank's website, the DDR5 Dark Heatsink UDIMM 6000MHz sports SK Hynix A-Die memory chips, which should give plenty of headroom for those of you out there intending to overclock your memory modules. Something that I really appreciate is the fact that these memory modules come with both AMD Expo and Intel XMP profiles, as per the BIOS snapshots on the screen. This means there's no need to purchase Expo-specific modules for AMD PC builds or Intel XMP-specific modules for Intel PC builds for that matter. The DDR5 Dark Heatsink can be used easily in both AMD and Intel systems. To put these KingBank memory modules through their paces, I've set up a test bench that is powered by AMD's new Ryzen 7 9800X3D with the following specs that can be seen on the screen, where I'll be pitting the KingBank DDR5 6000 CL28 memory modules against an offering from an established memory module brand, G.Skill, where I have on hand a 32GB Trident Z5 Neo RGB kit that is also running the same DDR5 6000 CL28 configuration. Do note that there are slight differences in the stock Expo memory timings for the G.Skill modules versus the KingBank modules. That aside, for the benchmark tests, the default Expo profiles were enabled for the entirety of testing, with no further tweaks to memory settings, and resizable BAR was switched on as well. In terms of OS, I used Windows 11 Pro 23H2 with all the latest updates installed as of the time of publishing this video, with VBS enabled as well. In terms of benchmarks, I'll be comparing the performance of the RAMs using 7-zip's compression and decompression benchmark test, Cinebench 2024, as well as the Corona 10 benchmark. I'll also be testing the RAMs using a suite of 3 in-game benchmark tests with a RTX 4090 at 1080p. We've got Black Myth Wukong, Cyberpunk 2077, as well as F1-23. On a side note, if you're new to the ALK Tech channel, do consider subscribing so as to keep up to date with the latest product releases in the PC hardware world. With that, let's get started. Let's take a look at the 7-zip compression and decompression test results. With the KingBank RAMs installed, we see that for the compression test, the test system was 1.1% faster than with the G.Skill RAMs installed, and for the decompression test, 0.4% slower, which is kind of a negligible performance difference in a benchmark context. Moving on to Cinebench 2024, with the KingBank RAMs, we see that the Ryzen 7 9800X3D attains a multi-core score of 1,362, versus 1,359 points when we've got the G.Skill RAMs installed. For single core scores, the 9800X3D gets a score of 133 with the KingBank RAMs and a score of 134 with the G.Skill RAMs, again a negligible performance difference. Rounding off this section on productivity benchmarks, as can be seen on the screen, The 9800X3D is 0.6% faster with the KingBank RAMs when it comes to the Corona 10 rendering benchmark test. For gaming performance, first up, we've got Black Myth Wukong, where the performance of the test system is pretty much identical with the KingBank and G.Skill RAMs, where in both instances, the test system achieves an average FPS of 162. Things are pretty much the same too for Cyberpunk 2077's in-game benchmark, where the test system achieves nearly the same average FPS. With the KingBank RAMs, we get an average FPS of 264.55 versus 263.84 with the G.Skill RAMs. Finally, with F1 23's in-game benchmark test, again, we see that the test system puts out pretty similar average FPS figures when comparing the results obtained with the KingBank RAMs installed versus the G.Skills. With the KingBanks, the test system achieves an average FPS of 463 versus 462 with the G.Skill RAMs. And with that, it can be seen that the performance of the KingBank RAMs is pretty much on par or even a teeny bit better than those from a more established brand with similar specs, where the key thing going for the KingBank RAMs is its price, which is extremely competitive, especially if you were to compare them to more established brands such as Corsair, G.Skill, Kingston, and so on. Now, the RAMs are available to purchase from KingBank's official AliExpress store, where I've included the purchase link in the video description down below. As per the screenshot that you can see on the screen, the RAMs can be bought for around SGD 155, and prices can go even lower when there are site-wide promotional campaigns ongoing, such as during the 11/11 Singles Day campaign, where as of the time of recording this video, the RAMs are going for a limited time price of around SGD 149 during this year's 11/11 sales campaign on AliExpress. There's absolutely no way you can get a brand new CL28 DDR5 6000 memory kit for such a low price in Singapore from your usual mainstream brands. The same applies for you international viewers, where I'm quite confident the promotional price of around $97 or even the non-promotional prices for that matter can't be beat by your mainstream DDR5 memory brands. It's worth noting too that KingBank does produce other DDR5 memory modules of different speeds and cache latencies, so if you're looking for memory faster than DDR5 6000 for instance, KingBank's got you covered with products such as DDR5 7200 memory modules and so on. Now, although the memory modules in this video were sponsored by KingBank, I must say I'm really impressed by the RAM's build quality, performance, and most importantly, its price, making it a set of RAMs that I recommend if you're on the lookout for a value for money, low latency DDR5 6000 memory for your AMD or Intel PC build. And with that, thank you so much for watching, hit the like button and get subscribed if you've enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you guys around the next time.